Number one, Solomon is dead. Question from the prophet card: what happened to Israel when Solomon died? What happened to the kingdom?
It divided.
It divided geographically, east, west, north or south. Which way? North, south. All right, you've got it. You've got Bible maps in the back of your Bible. Here you've got it. This is where the promised land is. See it at various times. That's the promised land. And so you're in this land, and the kingdom of God reaches under the time of Solomon all the way up to Iran, almost to Iraq. Or to Iraq, almost to Iran. I'll get it right this time. Got all the way up there, all the way down almost to Egypt. Great world power, great influential world power, even known by the Queen of Sheba, which is down on the southeastern corner of Saudi Arabia. I mean, you stop and think about it. She traveled 1,500 miles, close to 1,500 miles, at least over 1,000, to come up because she'd heard the wisdom of Solomon. Solomon dies. What happens to the kingdom? It's over. I said in the lesson just a moment ago, 85% of the kingdom turned their back on God and thereby turned their back on sharing in the promises of God. I'll make of you a great nation, put you in a great land, and send a great Savior. And they turned to a piece of gold that looked like a cow. I want you to understand the decision they made. I found an easier way to serve God. And so, what does Jeroboam do? Well, the question is, who were the first kings? If I say Jeroboam, who would you reckon would be the other one? It helps if you know they rhyme. Sue, I grew up in the church, and I thought they were identical twins. I grew up in the church, I just worked out all of these Bible problems, and everybody had names that sounded like were twins. So I was sure Solomon had sons, one, and they were named Rehoboam and Jeroboam. I could never have been more wrong. Jeroboam was the son of Nebat. Rehoboam was the son of Solomon. And so they even turned their house on the back of David, on the house of David. You've got to understand what's happened. They've given up on God. Now, how many tribes were there in the northern kingdom? If there are 12 tribes in all and 85% of them walked away from God, about what percentage of them walked away? 10 of the 12 tribes walked away. 10 of them. And there's tiny little kingdom of, the tribe of Judah, and the smaller, much smaller tribe, the tribe of Benjamin. And the rest of them left God. You've got to understand that. And the book of 1 Kings tells us about this division. And so we start tonight, we pick up where we left off. We got up to the death of Solomon. We then laid aside the death of Solomon and went to the poetical books because they were written during this time. And so we cover those books that were written by David and Solomon. Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon. We studied that. Now we're getting back on the history mark. And so the kingdom is divided. And there's a northern kingdom. What's the name of the northern kingdom? Israel. Do you remember the way I do? What's the name of the southern kingdom? I and J, right? Here's your eyes, here's your jaw, okay? Israel to the north, Judah to the south. And if you're having trouble, just ask Dan, what weird way did you stick that in your head? And that's the way it sticks. You know, it's the only way I can get it to stick in it. But I'm telling you, I love my way of remembering better than your way of forgetting it, okay? But your mind's got to be put in, brains in there backwards and everything. You've got to understand the truth about that. So you've got the northern kingdom. How many kings were there in the northern kingdom? How many kings in the southern kingdom? 19. How many godly kings were in the northern kingdom? 0. How many godly kings were there in the southern kingdom that really tried to serve God? Some of them partially served God. How many of them would you count as being God-fearing and faithful to God? 4. 4 out of 38 kings serve God. So the southern kingdom is not all that much better than the northern kingdom. But one of the questions that is asked there is the, let me get down to it. The righteous kings in the southern kingdom, must be a prophet, priest, must be a priest question. Four righteous kings, Asa, Jehoshaphat, Hezekiah, and Josiah. I wish Bobo were here. You remember how he taught us this? He stood over there when we had four groups over there, and I walked over there, and he helped me do this. He's going, Asa, Asa, like he was a Japanese fat wrestler, you know. Asa, Asa. Asa stands over there. He stood here, and I went and said, and what's your name? He's saying, so fat, so fat, so fat. Who's the other righteous king? Jehoshaphat. And then I walked over, and he was standing over here, and it's obvious he has something in his hands. King, what do you have in your hand? He has a kia. That's what he has. He has keys. He has a kia, okay? And so that's the name of that guy, Hezekiah. And then he went over to the last section, and he was going, ah, ah. He's sighing. Four righteous kings, Asa, Jehoshaphat, Hezekiah, and Josiah. I don't know if that helps you at all or not, but it really has helped me. Now then, where, and this is not one of the questions, but where do I find the names of those 19 southern kings? In one place. Where can I find the names of a listing of those 19 kings of the southern kingdom? Matthew 1, the begets. And that to me is such a vital thing in being able to be a soldier of Christ and use the Old Testament. Look in Matthew chapter 1, we read about the death of Solomon. And Solomon begat Rehoboam. And Rehoboam begat Asa. And Asa begat Jehoshaphat. Who'd Rehoboam begat? June's frowned at me. Rehoboam begat Abijah, and Abijah begat Asa, and Asa begat Jehoshaphat. And so for a while, two of the four righteous, Asa and Jehoshaphat, are there. And then curtains. Curtains all the way, almost to the end of the southern kingdom. And all of a sudden, Hezekiah comes on the scene. Right before the southern kingdom is destroyed, Hezekiah comes on the scene, and they're brought back to God. Guess what happens when Hezekiah stops being the king? His son's Manasseh. They forget about God, wicked king. And so you've got Manasseh, you've got Ahab. You've got all of these southern kings and everything, terrible and wretched. And 25 years before the end of the southern kingdom, Josiah comes on the scene. That's First Kings, folks. And that's what we're trying to do, is to survey the Bible. You see it on the prophet card, the number of kings in the northern kingdom. You see that? You see the number of kings in the southern kingdom, the number of righteous king in the north, the four righteous kings of the southern kingdom. That is not on the prophet card. It's on the other card. Now up in the northern kingdom, back to the prophet card. Who's the king up there? Who's the most famous king of the northern kingdom? Not Jeroboam.
Ahab.
Ahab and what's her name?
Jezebel.
Ahab and Jezebel. And so what's First Kings all about? It's a historical record of the divided kingdom. And so the lesson tonight talked about how it came about. Where did the denominations come about? Where did the false religion of the northern kingdom come about? It came about because of a political religious decision that Jeroboam made so he could remain to be king. And people make all kinds of decisions so they will be popular and they make it a matter of convenience and ignoring what God says, and they sort of make it like what God says. It makes everybody feel real good. You're religious. We don't do it on the seventh month. We do it on the eighth month because that fits our culture better. That's what this whole story is all about. Whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning. Are we never going to learn? How much of the Bible we got to read before we learn? This is what it's all about. This simple story from 1 Kings chapter 12 and 1 Kings chapter 13. You got to spend time there and see what happened. Israel, the powerful kingdom of Solomon, ceases to be. Why? Because they disobeyed God. There's a question somewhere on here about the what the prophet said. Look in 1 Kings chapter 14. Got your Bible? Here is an incident that happened. There is this message that is given in 1 Kings chapter 14. And the question is, I cannot find the question. Here's the answer to the question. Moreover, the Lord will raise up for himself a king over Israel who will cut off the house of Jeroboam. What's going to happen to Jeroboam? For all that he did, 1 Kings chapter 14, verse 14, he's going to be cut off. He's going to be his sons, and grandsons will not be the kings. There were about four different dynasties of all those 19 different kings that are up there. All of a sudden, they just get rid of the king, get rid of all of his family, and kill all of his kids in relationship. Now, here's the amazing thing. The reason this was going to happen is because in him there was found something good toward the God of Israel in the house of Jeroboam. Moreover, the Lord will raise up for himself a king over Israel who shall cut off the house of Jeroboam. That is his day. What? Even now, for the Lord will strike Israel as a reed shaken in the water. He will uproot Israel, northern kingdom, right after and even while Jeroboam is leaving. The prophet of God says he's going to wipe out the house of Jeroboam. He will uproot Israel from the good land which he gave to their fathers and will scatter them beyond the river, up beyond the Euphrates River, because they have made their wooden images, provoking the Lord to anger. You've got to understand, right as it happened, the God of heaven said, let me tell you what's going to happen. First, you're going to see Jeroboam's house wiped out. And then you're going to find the destiny of that northern kingdom. Long-suffering of God. 200 years he let those 19 kings of the northern kingdom lead the people in rebellion against God. And then he did what he said he was going to do. I'm taking this northern kingdom and I'm taking them beyond the river. You know what nation there is up there? Assyria. And that's exactly what happened to this northern kingdom. God said he was going to do it, and 200 years later, he wiped out. The prophet said, speaking for God, listen to God say it three times, I will overthrow the house of Israel. Why? Because they provoke God to anger. Folks, you've got to do what God says. And this is one of those stories in the Bible that talks about how long-suffering God is. I don't know any of us who'd be that patient. For 19 kings, one after another, not a single one of them said, let's return back to God. Jehu sort of got close, but he never made it. Let's turn back to God. It's not going to happen. Not a single godly king. And so that northern kingdom went into Assyrian captivity. What is the book of 1 Kings all about? First 11 chapters? Solomon. What happens when Solomon dies? And there are all of these stories that are really, really important. Because you've got these kings, but we focused on the kings. Can we come back now and talk about the prophets? Do you know the last 17 books of prophecy of the Bible are books of prophecy? 39 books in the Old Testament, and almost half of them, 17 out of 39, were written after the death of Solomon. 17 of the 39 books of the Old Testament were written to 38 kings, and then after those kings no longer ruled, and both northern and southern nations went into captivity and returned from captivity, during that period of time, the last 17 books of the Bible are written. Now, what we did is that we studied historically and got all the way up through the Exodus, Joshua into the Promised Land, ruled in the Promised Land by judges. They asked for a king. God gives them three kings for, 40 years each, 120 years, Saul, David, and Solomon. And then we stopped. Why did we stop studying that? And why do we stop in 1 Kings chapter 11? Because we then turned and looked at the books, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, that were written during the times of David and Solomon. Then we've come back. And we've come back to 1 Kings, and we've started right in 1 Kings chapter 12, where the kingdom is divided. That was the sermon, and that's the class tonight. What happens when Solomon dies? And we're going to study the historical part of it. Where are we going to find it? We're going to find it in 1 Kings, 2 Kings, 1 and 2 Chronicles, and then when they come back from the captivity, Ezra, Nehemiah, and Esther. Guess what's happening? During that period of time, during the time of 1 Kings chapter 12, as we introduce tonight, all the way through Ezra, Nehemiah, and Esther, the last 17 books of the Bible are being written. Your friends, and when you first start reading the Bible, will think it is all historical. And you start in Genesis, and you read it all the way through, and it's all chronological. That is not the nature of it. The books of the Bible, think of them being on a library shelf. And on the library shelf, there are the books of Moses, first shelf. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. What happens in those books? The nation of Israel is born. And so then you've got 12 other historical books. Those first five books are the law, books of Moses, but we call them the law, but there's probably more history in them than there is law. The law given by Moses and the accounts of it, Genesis through Deuteronomy. Second shelf, the next 12 books, Joshua through Esther on the next shelf, historical books. And then you go to the public library, you've got a section where you have the poems, poetry, literature. And that's what you have. The poems on one shelf, Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon. And then you've got a book that has the last 17 books. And that's what you read about, 1 Kings through Esther. That's the introduction. We're trying to get this finished, and we're going to go rapidly. We're trying to speed up because it's going to happen in January, David, is that where it's going to start? We're going to start an amazing study of the life of Jesus. I have learned more of the life of Jesus in the last 18 months working with David, studying the life of Jesus. I have learned things I never even knew were in the Bible. I am so excited and hardly wait for January. You are dismissed for tonight.